This is Nina Curley of WAMDA Media. I'm here at the World Economic Forum with Yasar Jarar, who's a partner at Bain & Company. Yasar, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Great. So you came and actually attended our Mix and Mentor the other day before the WEF began. What were your impressions from the session there? What were the biggest challenges that you saw entrepreneurs facing?
Well, the session was really uplifting. I mean, amidst everything we see in the Arab world now, to see young people living their dreams, so to speak, and taking action, establishing their companies. So generally, it was a very positive attitude. The first impression I got was they need some help, but not the help we thought they need. So we always focus on finance. And the question when we talked about fundraising was some of them saying, why should we fundraise? Well, that's not our biggest issue. So it just brought me down to the grassroots of what entrepreneurs need. They genuinely said, I probably want somebody on my advisory board to help me identify the right timing, the right tipping point for my business, to look at my business model and tell me if it's going in the right direction. So they would love and they appreciated the mentorship, but they taught us what actually their challenges are and the fact that, you know, what we hypothesize on is not necessarily what's on the ground.
How does this compare to other ecosystems that you've seen or been a part of?
The ecosystem is not that well structured. If you go to places like Silicon Valley, it's within months that you get to meet a VC, you get to structure an advisory board. People are willing, people believe. I think that's one thing one of the young ones told me when I said, what was your experience in Silicon Valley and what? How does it compare to when you were come back home? And he said the biggest difference is everybody I met there believes. So here we're still one step away from that. They probably struggled to convince an investor. They struggled to convince an advisory board member. They were very skeptical when we said, we can help. We can be advisors to you. They said, why? What's in it for you? We said, because we want to help. So it just struck me that they probably need more people around them who believe. And hopefully the young global leaders from the WEF can be one part of that.
So when it comes to your work, I mean, and also enabling entrepreneurs, government plays a huge role. What do you think the appropriate role is for government in supporting entrepreneurs? And how can governments be more efficient at what they do?
First of all, make it easier for them. At the moment, most of the Arab world, startups are not that easy. In some of the Gulf countries, we don't even have a bankruptcy law. Debts are punishable by law. So there's something about having an ecosystem that governments should, in terms of setting up a business, in terms of availability of finance from banks, they should encourage banks to fund a little bit more. So there's a whole bunch of things government can do to build the ecosystem. And I think the governments have spent most of their energy on building funds to provide their own support. And maybe that's not what they should be doing. Maybe they should look at the wider ecosystem.
And when it comes to making governments more efficient in general, we were speaking about a few recommendations in the panel we just saw. Can you speak to those?
I think the one advice we keep giving to governments is bring in a performance-driven culture. A performance-driven culture means you publicly announce some results you want to achieve. You publicly hold officials accountable for delivering those results. And you revamp all your system to make the jobs in government performance-driven and not simply jobs for life as a part of a social employment. So I think performance-driven, that's a lesson we can learn from the private sector. It has been done. Singapore has done it in their own government. In recent years, I think that has changed in our part of the world. And very clear results-driven government, I think, is the future.